It seems as though these days, everybody is jumping in their cars and ranting and raving about something. So I decided I would jump on the bandwagon and rant and rave about something. But in my case, I'm going to jump into my Dodge Avenger and sit here in my driver's seat behind my steering wheel and give you a rant. As an etiquette instructor, just about everywhere I go and everything I do, I find an etiquette lesson that can be learned or taught. And in most cases, these etiquette tips could be very helpful to adults. Now, I'm not one that's just up in somebody's face, but there are times that I just want to go up to people and say, hey, could you please wake up and mind your manners? Could you please go back over here and pick up your trash? Could you please go back into the bathroom and wash your hands after you use the bathroom, for heaven's sakes? Or could you please go back over here and push your chair in? Well, here's my rant number one, because I have many rants and many pet peeves. But one of my pet peeves is this. I don't really like to go grocery shopping, but I'm having to run to the grocery store at least two or three times a week because guess what? My family, well, they like to eat. So when I gather my list and I run to the grocery store and I go up to find the perfect basket to push in the store, after I've gone through 50 to find the perfect one that will even push, I don't even know why they keep the old ones. Why can't they just get rid of them or fix them? I don't know. It's a mystery. So I finally find my grocery basket that I want to push around in this big old grocery store. So I'm going down the aisles and I'm looking at my list and I'm trying to concentrate because it's not one of my favorite things to do is to gather groceries. I just want to get in there, get my stuff and get out. But instead, I'm having to dodge everybody's basket or every apple or orange that has been tossed onto the floor that nobody has the decency to pick up and put back on the shelf. No, I'm having to listen to all these little kids screaming, yeah, I want donuts, I want chocolate, I want the Nerf gun. I don't really care about that. I don't want to hear that. But another thing that I see these parents doing with these kids that are screaming in the stores continually when you're trying to shop, they try to give them these big devices. And while they're sitting in their basket, they put the child on the basket and they give them this humongous device to play with. All right, I'm fine with that. Give them a device to play with. Keep them quiet, whatever you got to do, right? But I don't care if they're playing Pac-Man or Mario Brothers or learning their ABCs from Sesame Street. Could you please turn down the volume? There is a volume switch on those devices, people. Learn how to use it. So as you can see, when I'm going to the grocery store, I can see so many etiquette lessons and things that I would like to teach people. But one of the things that really gets on my nerves and bothers me the most when I am at a grocery store is not too much about the kids screaming in the basket. But it's the fact when I am through gathering my groceries and I walk up to the counter and I put my groceries onto this conveyor belt, which just quickly takes it down to this nice smiley little checker. We all know that's not true, but that's another rant we'll have to give later. So I put my groceries onto the conveyor belt and another happy little shopper comes up behind me and decides that they don't want to respect my personal space. So they take their basket and push it up as far as they can up to my space. So when I turn around, I can see what kind of butter they're using on their biscuit. Well, I don't really care what kind of brand of butter that you're putting on your biscuit or the jelly that you use on your peanut butter and jelly sandwich. I want you to please get back, move back, give me space, people, so that I can check out my groceries and pay for them and get out of there. But that's not always the case. I'm always dealing with somebody who does not respect personal space. Now, is this just me or does this bother you as well? I'm sure it does, but you just don't want to admit it, right? Or you don't want to sit into your driver's seat behind your steering wheel and rant and rave about it. So I'll do it for you. Here's the etiquette tip, and I don't know if this is written in any etiquette book or Emily's post-etiquette book, but I'm going to write it in my etiquette book, the Lisa Domenico Harris etiquette book. Rule number one, when you're checking out groceries and you're standing at the counter and there's more than one person, the one checking out their groceries has the right to the space, the conveyor belt, the cash register, the clerk. The person behind the person checking out does not have that space yet. They are next in line, but that does not give them the right to push their way to the front. So keep your distance. Stay behind the conveyor belt. Do not start throwing all your groceries on top of someone else's groceries until they are finished checking it completely out, and then it's your turn. It's called minding your space, respecting other people's space. It's not hard to do. It's easy. So the next time you go to the grocery store, why don't you look around and see who's doing that to you, or maybe you're the one doing it to them. Either way, go out and mind your manners and respect others' space.